Artaban, joined by three fellow magi from other orders, spent the next year and a half studying the Zoroastrian and Hebrew prophecies and searching the heavens for signs of Attar's birth. He became so engrossed in his work that he forgot all else, including the affairs of his fellow magi. Artaban's father, Darius, was the Magupaiti, or leading Magus in Hamadan. With his health deteriorating, the other magi speculated as to whom Darius might select as his successor. Although Artaban and his two closest friends, Rashne and Kaveh, were all viable candidates for the position, most believed that Darius would select his own son. "But you do not want to be Magupaiti," Rashne said to Artaban late one evening. "You have said so yourself." "True," Artaban admitted. But I do," Rashne interrupted. "Please, Artaban, speak to your father on my behalf." "You should talk to him yourself, Rashne. He will listen to you." "But the brethren speak ill of me," Rashne exclaimed, "and Darius will listen more to you than to me. Besides, I will not be able to talk to him for several weeks. I am leaving for Susa tomorrow morning at my father's urgent request. His silk business is suffering at the hands of conniving Jewish businessmen. So will you speak to your father, please?" Artaban sighed, then nodded his head. "Thank you, dear friend," Rashne said, embracing him. "I will not forget your kindness." Rashne departed, and Artaban returned his focus to the scrolls before him. Soon all thought of what he had promised his friend slipped from his mind. When Rashne returned to Hamadan a month later, having been unsuccessful in saving his father's business, he was shocked to find Darius had already chosen Artaban as the next Magupaiti. A few days after Rashne's return, Artaban requested a gathering of the order. The magi came together, and, as was custom, Darius started the meeting by leading the magi in a hymn.